Hey friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Mercy. Thank you for clicking on this video. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about a couple of tips here and there for international students on how you can save your money, especially if you're a new student or you're planning to join any Western world for school. There are a couple of tips here and there, and I hope this video is going to be helpful. Because you know what, there are so many things you're supposed to pay when you're an international student. You're supposed to pay school fees, you're supposed to pay for bills, transport, food, accommodation, all the other kind of stuff. So if you like this kind of content, don't forget to like, share this video with your friends. Like I always say, it does help with the growth of my channel. Thank you guys, and keep watching the video. Say goodbye. The first tip I'm going to talk about is accommodation, shared accommodation. Living in a shared accommodation is going to help you save so much, because of course you're going to be living with other people, and there's a lot of inconveniences here and there. But let me tell you, living in a shared accommodation for the period that you're gonna be in school, it's gonna help you save so much money. Let's assume you're living with one or two people. It all depends with your friends, or sometimes you don't even have to know the people you're living with. And probably you're gonna be paying $150 per week for rent, or $300 per fortnight. But when you're living alone, I can tell you this, you're not gonna be paying anything less than 500 or 600 a fortnight, you know. But when you're living with people, you're gonna save so much. You're gonna save like half the rent or even more than that, you know. And let's assume if you're living by yourself, you pay rent $400, no, not even 400, $600 minimum. It's gonna be $600 a fortnight, so a month you're gonna be paying more than $1,000. But when you're living with people, you can get a house for $100, $150, but that is per week, $200 per week, you know, and you're gonna save so much money. The next tip I'm gonna talk about is budgeting. Make sure you have a budget and stick to that budget. A budget is gonna ensure that you are tracking your expenses, and at the same time it's going to ensure that you're not spending more money than what you're earning. Because if you find yourself you're spending more money than what you're earning, at the end of the day it's not a good thing. It's not going to be good for you. So always make sure you have a budget. What are you supposed to pay every fortnight? What is important for you? Rent, fuel or transport, food, school fees, and all that kind of thing, you know. It's gonna help you. It's gonna remind you as well what you're supposed to pay, the most important bills that you're supposed to pay. The next tip I'm gonna talk about is living within your means. Please just live within your means. If you cannot afford that latest iPhone, well and good, you know. If you can't afford the latest car, expensive car, and all that kind of stuff, it's all right. Once you finish school, you're gonna afford all those things. But for now, you're a student. Live in a house that you can afford, you know. Use a phone that you can afford. Buy a car that you can afford, so that you're able, when it comes to paying school fees, you're not gonna be straining too much, you know, because you spend all your money on expensive liquor, expensive holidays, you know, expensive cars. Avoid buying things that you don't need, you know. Avoid having too much clutter in your house. Could be clothes, you know, could be any other stuff in your house. Please make sure whatever you're buying, just ask yourself, do I really need this item that I'm buying? Do I need this outfit? Do I need this? If you find yourself that you're not sure whether you need it or not, you don't have to buy. I'm sure when you look at your house and you see the amount of things that you don't need, you don't even use, that is money down the drain. And I'm not even judging anyone because I'm one of those people. Like, I have so much junk, which I really don't need, and so many clothes sometimes. I'm not trying to live a minimalist life, to be honest, but I can tell you this, there are so many things in your house, in my house, that I really don't need and probably I'll never wear. So please, when you're a student, just buy the necessary things. Buy the things that you need. Avoid buying clutter, junk, you know, buying things because they are on sale. There are so many sales, like there was Black Friday this week, or is it last week? I don't know. Like Christmas sales are coming. You just find yourself accumulating stuff that you don't even need. You find that they're selling things 30% or 50% off, and say, wow, this is a good bargain. And you don't need that outfit. You don't even need that item. You're just buying it because it is on sale. But if you ask yourself, do I really need this thing, or am I buying it because it is on sale? Most likely you're buying it because it is on sale. And I'm talking about myself as well, because I do that, really. I need to stop. I need to be stopped. Because that is just wasted money. Probably you're not even gonna wear that outfit. You're not gonna use that item that you're buying. You're just buying it because it's on sale. Oh, please. These are the kind of things that we weren't taught in school. To you, so I can be close to you. It's really simple. The next tip I'm gonna talk about is please avoid loans, debts, you know, credit cards by all means if you can. You know, if you cannot afford that expensive car, you can always, and you want to finance it and you're a student, just buy a small affordable car, you know, that can move from one destination to another. After all, you're not going to be a student for long. You're going to be a student for 1, 2, 3, or 4 years, and then you can afford the expensive car that you want. You don't have to get those credit card, you know, or to take a loan and all that kind of stuff. I don't know, not unless it is so necessary, because sometimes you may find yourself, you don't have enough school fees, you know, you don't have anyone to lend you money and you want to pay your school fees. Probably in that case you can get a loan and all that kind of stuff. But if you can, please try as much as possible to avoid debt, credit card. There's so many apps that there's another app, what's the name? There are those apps of buy now, pay later, you know, avoid all those apps, let me tell you. Even that $30 or $40 that you get deducted after every month, that is money. You know, it might not seem a lot, but when you calculate the whole amount at the end of a certain period, it's gonna be a lot of money. That is just my opinion. Some people might have a different opinion, and there is nothing wrong with that, in having different opinions, you know. So for me, that is what I would do, is avoiding debt at all cost. Last but not least, please remember to take care of yourself. It is very, very important. Take care of your mental health. Take care of your well-being, you know. Talk to someone if you're not feeling okay. Talk to your family, talk to your friends if you have to, or seek professional help. And I did a video, I don't know, a couple of days ago or 1 week, about how to take care of your mental health. I'm gonna leave a link in the description box below, and you can watch that video. Remember, you come first. Anyone else comes second. You come first. You're the most important person in your life, so you need to take care of yourself. With that said, we've come to the end of this video. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you for the likes. Thank you for the shares. Thank you for the new subscribers. I'll keep saying that because I don't take all that for granted. And like I always say in my video, I'll never stop saying this. Be kind to one another. It doesn't cost anything to be kind to one another. If you cannot say good things, encouraging things to people, just say nothing. I'll see you in my next video. Thank you. It's really simple if you look at it that way.